Ihr mit Heiße?
Ihr mit von København?
Gode sager.
Ja, lad os se, hvad der er.
Heidi og Reini her.
Ah.
Og et kæmpe glasmusik af Vilmantas.
Og hvad er det? En masse podier, eller hvad er det?
Det er podier.
Jeg siger, hvad er det? Ah, ej, hvor er han fræk.
Skide godt. En mere her, som jeg virkelig har passet meget på. Tralala.
Yes. Der er noget udtryk i ham.
Det er der.
Ja.
Altså,
det skal vi altså lige se.
Ja.
Hold op. Det var typisk Vilmantas tænder. Og den ser god ud.
Det er jo faktisk et rigtig godt billede, men det passer ikke rigtig ind i den her sammenhæng, så det skal enten flyttes et andet sted hen, eller også skal det ud af udstillingen, fordi netop fordi det ikke rigtig passer sammen med de andre ting.
Nej, det går ikke. Vi skal have den der væk igen.
Er vi en halv? Den der?
Ja, det tror jeg. Ja. Jeg tror ikke, det giver mening. Jeg tror, vi skal have... Jeg ved ikke. Jeg tror ikke, vi skal have den der igen. Enten skal vi være alene, og så skal vi have... Eller også skal vi have den skitsen tilbage igen på den plads. Ja, det er også en mulighed. Hej.
Hej.
Ved du, Henrik, vi kunne godt prøve at se, om vi kunne tage mobiltelefonen derover i stedet for. Og så tager vi hende der, nej, hende derover, tager hende tilbage herover.
Den her?
Ja.
Hvor
hende
her?
Bare sæt den forløbet derover. Og så mobiltelefonen derover. Nej, den derovre.
Den der?
Ja.
Og vi ser til højre?
Ja, eller bare på hele væggen. Og så tager vi... Jeg er forsigtig med den, ja.
Back to the memory.
Yeah, thank you, Torgil, for showing and calling me. Yeah.
That's okay. All right. Bye bye.
Bye.
Han tog sgu godt imod det. Det er lidt heldigt. Ikke også? Det er en tæt udstilling, men den er stærk. Så hjertelig velkommen til alle jer fantastiske mennesker. Hjertelig velkommen til kunstnerne, til Heidi og Reini. Velkommen til Vilmantas, som står herover og som næsten forstår dansk efterhånden. Fordi han har været pænt mange gange. Og hjertelig velkommen til dig, Søren, fordi du vil runde det her lille intermezzo af med din tale. Vi har rykket NBX op i stueplanet her, sådan så vi i stedet for at skulle stå nedenunder i det gamle NBX dernede, så er vi nu heroppe. Og det er derinde, vi nu udstiller Heidi og Reini, og det er første gang, hun er her. Og det er faktisk nok også første gang, du overhovedet er i Viborg, måske lige frem. Ja. Så, så det er jo det er også en måde at lade folk lære landet at kende på. Det har de inviteret dem til at lave udstillinger her i Viborg, så lærer de byen at kende. Og jeg håber, at I også får tid til at komme ud og kigge noget andet af byen, ikke også? Fordi det er jo en fantastisk by, som vi bor i her. Heidi har lavet en række skulpturer inde ved siden af, som er lavet i Rappenbrand der. Og det er alt sammen, det handler om tilstande, som vi siger. Det er det, overskriften er på udstillingen. Og det er i virkeligheden sådan, så når I, det er godt, vi ikke skal stå derinde og lave den her tale, ikke også? Fordi så er de jo væltet alle sammen. Men det er sådan, at de figurer derinde, de ligner ufattelig mange af jer. Nogen er rigtig glade, og nogen er lidt skræmte, og nogen er lidt trætte af det hele, og andre de er meget, meget forundret, og en står og sidder og piller næse, og hvad har vi? Det er hele spektret af tilstande, som Heidi hun kommer omkring der. Og det synes jeg faktisk, du gør rigtig fantastisk udmærket. Oven i det, så har du også nogle bobler derinde. Nogle, som du siger, er nogen, der er ved at bryde ud af deres sindstilstand, måske.
Ja, så siger det dem, der er rammebrændet. De andre er spændtagsbrændet.
Ja, okay. Spændtagsbrændet tungt. Mads Nielsen, han sagde en gang, hvor vi skulle åbne bjerg til skolen, men så stadigvæk levede og stadigvæk var stærk, en stærk mand. Det var ham, der også byggede gymnastikhøjskolen. Han sagde også, glem alle de små bump på vejen. Sørg for at strides hesten i fart, så mærker man ikke de små bump. Og det var lige præcis sådan en, du havde der. Vi springer over de små bump, og så tager vi de store linjer i stedet for. Men det der egentlig, det er, at de der bobler derinde der, det er sådan nogen, der lægger mærke til, at der er sådan en, hånd eller en lille finger eller et eller andet, der piller og gerne vil også ud over hovedet. Og de øvrigt også hænger på væggen. Det er i sig selv også fuldstændig småskørt. Men, og vi har diskuteret, hvordan de skulle hænge, ikke også? Og de er blevet sænket 20 cm. Det er i sig selv også lidt vanvittigt. Nu forstår jeg måske, at der er også nogen af jer, der ikke er så høje som jeg er. Og der er også nogen, der er højere igen. Men så kan I så dreje den. Jeg ved ikke, om I skal gøre det i dag.
Nej.
Men I kan da overveje det, når I nu har købt dem og hængt dem op hjemme på væggen. Altså, I kan dreje dem, sådan at I kan dreje dem derhen, hvor I gerne vil se dem. Altså, så I får den rigtige vinkel på dem. Og de kan selvfølgelig også stå på bordet, som så meget andet. Jeg synes faktisk, du har lavet en fantastisk udstilling. Og det skal du have mange tak for. Spændende. Og det er første gang, du er her, og det kunne være, at det skulle fortsætte en anden god gang. Og så har vi så også, nu står vi i et rum her med Vilmantas, og det skal ikke sige så meget om, bortset fra, at om 2 år, så flyder han 50. Og der er det er faktisk sådan en småkonfirmand, vi har stående herovre. Men altså, når han bliver 50, så vi snakker om, at vi også skulle færdig med en udstilling og en lille bog og sådan nogle ting der. Og det kunne da være, at vi så ses igen omkring sådan en event også. Men derudover, så har du også lavet mange andre ting i forløbende tid, ikke også? Og her mandag formiddag tager vi igen til Hedager Kirke, fordi vi skal diskutere en prædikestol, som også måske skal have noget udsmykning. Og så fremdeles. Og sådan er der altid gang i en hel masse bag ved alt det, som I ellers kender til daglig. Det I ser, facaden er kun lidt af det. Så nu skal jeg passe på, for ellers kunne I godt fortælle rigtig mange ting. Men der har vi jo så altså Søren, som nu overtager ordet her, og som fortæller lidt om Vilde Mantas og udstillingen. Velkommen til, Søren.
Tak.
Kan I forstå det på engelsk, hvis det bliver sagt på engelsk?
Ja.
Dem, der ikke kan forstå det, de siger det selvfølgelig ikke. Det er okay.
Jeg havde forstået, at det skulle være på engelsk. Og thank you. Thank you for inviting me for this event. It's an honor and a pleasure to be able to open this part of opening this exhibition with the fine artists. The first time I heard about Vilmantas was when we built the dormitories down close to the stadium, the houses for the students, with these big paintings, as the French Siri. That was very, very impressive. Since then, you have also, when we celebrated the 950 years as a city of the cathedral. We bought, the municipality bought one of the pictures, the Last Supper, and gave it as a present to the church, to the cathedral, to the bishop. And now it's hanging there, very beautiful in, I don't know what it, what the name is in English, men landemodesalen. So, it's a very fantastic picture, and that reminds me to say you have done some fantastic things about the religious art. I think you saw you have had some religious paintings, you have some art work in churches. Here you have some glass mosaics. We see also you're working on it in a church, and I think that's very impressive to do that, to create something in a church who is a public room in the Danish society, you know, to go to a church and see something and be aware that when you do that for the public, that's one thing. When you make your own art as a painting, that's another. And also I think if you look at your religious art, some of it is good, it's more private, and someone in the church, that's another thing. I think it's very amazing and fantastic what you have done there. You have many, your paintings have many faces and expressions. If I sit every night, no, not every night, when I'm sometimes sitting in my living room, once or twice a week, if I'm watching the TV, I look up and I have a painting you have made, a painting of one of your, I would say, many faces. Sometimes I forget looking at the TV and look at the painting, because it gives so much when you look at the way you are painting. The painting, these fantastic strong colors you have been done, the blue, the yellow, sometimes the red, and now I can see you are moving on to use other kind of colors. I think that's very interesting, but your very strong colors, is you always know Evan Manta's pictures when you see it. If a person who have seen one of your pictures will always recognize if you're the artist, I'm sure, because it's so clear what's Evan Manta's painting, and I think it's characteristic. And that's what I find so inspiring, these colors, just the colors alone and the way you put them together. It's amazing. And also when you add the expressions to that, it's very, very interesting. I had the pleasure of having a lunch with the ambassador from your country, and we, in 5 or 10 minutes, we started to talk about, oh, have you heard about the artist in Manta? Oh, yeah. Oh, we talk about. He told me a lot about the pictures which you have been lending them. It's fantastic, fantastic talk. And I'm so lucky because it's so that in the parliament in Denmark and in the ministry, you can choose how you decorate your office. And normally, Danish politicians can choose from a catalog, from the Danish art museum, Statens Museum for Kunst, where we can choose pictures. And a lot of the good pictures are already hanging in some of the politicians' offices, in some of the meeting room in Christiansborg. And the former Minister of Justice, he is born and raised in the Bornholm. So he had a Bornholm painter, and that was fine, but a little too dark for me. Then at the summertime, the office was painted, and I had to choose some pictures, and I got the catalog from what was left from the Danish museum. I just went through it, and it was just dark, dark, dark pictures. And I said, if I'm not getting suicidal, I have to do something else, because it's just dark pictures. I have to, when you walk into a room in an office, and you have the art on the walls, it should give something, it should amaze you, it should say something to you, you should debate it, you should ask about it, and you don't ask about just a dark picture. And that's, but then I called Torkel, and I said to him, do you think there's any possibilities that we can hang some pictures in my office. The good thing is there's absolutely no money in it, and because I can't do, or else I'll get in the front of the page on the paper. That's for sure. So, and he said, let's talk about it, and we talked about who and so, and I said, if it was at all possible, if pictures of if Will Mantas could be one of the artists, I'll be very happy. And then I was so lucky. I have four pictures now in my office. Two of the Danish painter, Carsten Frank, and two of which you have made. Actually, it's what someone would say back to the original Will Mantas, the friends picture, faces of friends. It's not exactly like this one hanging over here, but it's more blue in the middle, I think. It's bigger.
More light.
More light, yeah. And the other one is hanging over there. It's just much bigger than the one I have in my office. Yep, this one. And what is interesting is that since they have been hanged, the pictures, whenever people come to my office, they always stop, they look at the four pictures and then ask about them. They ask about them. We have a talk. Actually, if you're meeting with somebody, you know, this is going to be maybe a not so good meeting. Start by maybe they talk about this, ask about what these four pictures, people ask about them in many ways. And that's what art is meant to be, you know, things you discuss, what is that? And people ask me, what does he mean by that? And we have a lot of talks about that. And that's fantastic, that's how it should be. And also now I have seen, when I'm doing some interviews in my office, when it's in my office, the cameramen always come in and they have a very clear idea of what, where should it be and stuff. They look around and in a few seconds they say, okay, I stand here, you have this in the back. Almost do it every time, maybe you have seen it, some of you. So that's very good, and I think maybe it's, I hope people think it's a beautiful picture, so if I'm under a lot of pressure, maybe people don't listen to what I say, they just look at the picture. But that's the idea, and I'm so thankful that it was possible, that you wanna participate in this, and I've just seen these pictures in your mosaics, and I say, if I had money, I would buy some of these paintings. Well, I hope you get them all sold, because this is once again amazing what you have done. I am so impressed of the painting you do, and I just want to say thank you for giving us all high class art to look at, to discuss, to enjoy, and that must be the meaning of art. And I hope for you that we will see many exhibitions to come, and looking forward to when you're turning 50. I myself have another attitude to that. Years ago I thought 50, that was almost end of life. Now it's how I have it. Oh, it's just the new 40s in this kind of way. So we agree on that one. But thank you very much. Thank you for all the artwork you're doing, and I'm very honored to be a part of this opening ceremony of the exhibition. Thank you, and good luck with it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. I think that's new Danish culture minister. Could be, because you analyze so perfect artworks and an idea. And I think you mentioned very well, and it's not like these faces of friends, but I think if art can connect all of us together, it's like some we are friends for already 25 years, some 20 and with gallery, and some people are new, who just from last trip to Vilnius. So I think somehow art connect us in this space or around art, and I think it's one of the most important things that as an artist you can paint or create something that it makes interest to different people, and it talks to the people, and I think if we can find message that art is great, and we can, and we would like to live with such message or to see it, I think it makes us happy as an artist. You know? So thank you for gallery, thank you for colleague in another room. So I think we have today a very great opening. Thank you for the speech. Thank you.
Jamen, det er sgu helt rørende, ikke?
Jo.
Så tillykke med, at I får lov til at se sådan en flot udstilling. Udstilling her. Og jeg håber rigtigt, at I vil hygge jer med det. Og at I vil nyde både det i dag, men også at komme rigtig mange gange sidenhen. Og så få lov til at opleve det igen og igen. Hjertelig velkommen til alle sammen.
Tak.
Okay.